Guys, welcome back to my channel. If you're new to my channel, hi, I'm
Akanksha.
So it is the time of Navratri and I've decided I'll do 9-day series for Navratri. I don't really have a name for it, I'm sorry, but yeah, I'm going to post for 9 days, like different types of ideas, different themes. You are going to be makeup looks, you are going to be like about skincare or any such things. So this is one of the look I have for you. For the first day, I have this classic black smoky eye. I guess this is the look any Indian girl, you know, usually tries to wear, like for Indian or even, you know, when they're going out in the night. Black smoky eye is a standard thing, you can wear it on anything, but sometimes it gets a little messy and a little tricky to do it. So today I'm going to break it down and I'm going to tell a really, really easy way to do it. So without any further more blabbering, like I always do, let's get into the video. So I'm starting off with my base done. If you're a beginner, I would totally recommend you to start off with, you know, the eyes first, because you're going to have a lot of fallout. Like, because you're a beginner, you don't really understand how it works. So I, to avoid fallout, I usually bake. So I'm just going to do that. But if you're a beginner, I would, you know, advise you to start without the base done. So I'm just going to take a little powder and just bake under my eyes. And then we can, you know, just start with the black smoky eye. So this will properly bake my under eye as well, as you know, I can avoid fallout with this. Baking can also help the base stay in place for a longer period of time, because you're going to sweat and all when you're dancing. This just makes it stay for a very long time. So I'm just going to start off with a kajal. You can use a, like, you know, any kajal. Since I have a gel liner, I'm starting off with a gel liner. So I'm just taking this Maybelline Studio gel eyeliner. One thing you always have to remember is, like, let it be base, let it be eyes. Always start with less, and then if you need it, you can add more. Don't just go with a heavy hand, because if you're a beginner, it would always be really difficult, you know, to blend something you've already put on your eyes. Since I've primed my lids and my eyebrows are down, I'm directly going in. I just take this, the same brush it comes with, and I just apply in the centers. You don't want to apply it all over in the beginning, because like, black is very intense and a very difficult color to work with. So always, always, always go in with a light hand, and then you can always build it up from there. So I'm just taking that and I'm just going to add it in the center. Then once you keep blending it, the color is automatically going to, you know, just blend and buff all around the lid area. So I'm just taking that on the brush and I'm just going to add it. You can directly add a black eyeshadow and do it too, but you know, if you this just makes it very intense. Like, the black pigment is going to be seen very strongly when you add a, you know, cream based or a gel based eyeshadow. Concentrating it in the center of my lid and a little to the 3/4 end of my lid. Now just keep it till there, and then you can work from there. If you want, you can add more later after you blend it out, but don't add it now, because if, especially when the black gets out in the inner corner and stuff, it, you know, the whole look gets spoiled. You don't have a really brightened look. It just is going to look really dark and grayish all over the place. So just work very, you know, in with less. So, and work with, like, you know, one eye at a time if you're a beginner, because once the kajal dries down, it gets a little difficult to work with it. So I'm just going to take a pencil, pointed pencil brush type of thing, and I'm just going to blend the edges. Just make sure you don't go too much into the inner corner, because that's just going to mess up and, you know, just going to look very, very off, especially if you have small eyes and, you know, you don't have a lot of lid space. So once I'm done blending that cream a little bit, then I go in with the powder. This is my, like, a universal and a standard rule for me. Like, if I'm using a kajal, I always set it with a powder. So I'm just going to take this Beauty Bay palette, like Iron Bright palette. You can take any black eyeshadow. So this has a very proper matte black in it. So I'm just taking that and I'm just going to set and blend that part out. I'm just taking a point brush. This is the BH Cosmetics brush in the number 8. Just don't take a lot of black initially. You can just work with it. So I'm just taking whatever is it on the tip and I'm just going to set the whole, you know, kajal with it first. So that, you know, it just doesn't move all around. This just gave a really good intensified black look. So I'm just going to take the same brush and whatever is left over on the brush, I'm just going to blend the edges a little more. I'm making sure I don't go into the inner corner a lot. So that's, you know, pretty good, like, you know, for now to blend a black. And then I'm just going to blend the rest of it with brown. So this is just going to give a very gradient and very nice and blended look. I don't know how to explain it. It's just going to look very nice in the end. So I'm just going to take this brown and then just going to place it on the edges wherever the black is ending and I'm just going to buff it out. You can drag the black on the outer part how much ever you want, but just don't go into the inner so much. Next, I'm going to take the dark brown and I'm just going to add it between the brown I laid down and the black, just to add a little more. That's giving a very even and pretty blended look. So just that's all I do, just I keep on blending it. So I'm just going to take the lighter brown and keep on blending it until it's very perfectly blended and I'm happy with it. And after that, if I think I need a little black, I'll just take a black on a flat brush and just tap it in the areas where I think I need a little more black. So just let's do that. I'm just going to take a little black and just add it in the areas where I need a little more intense black. Just by laying it, I just buff it into the crease as well. So that's about it. It is that simple. So I'm just going to do the other eye off camera and I'll be back. So both my top lids are done. Now let's do the rest. Now I'm going in with the Plum Kajal and I'm just going to tight line my eyes and even my put this on my waterline as well. So tight lining your
2000 years later.
Upper lash is very necessary because, like, you know, once you wear lashes or you're putting mascara or anything, even if you don't wear lashes, like when you look up, the whole part is black, but you know, you can just see that white lid, you know, underneath. It's just going to look a little unpleasant and not a complete look. So I'm just going to take a kajal and just tight line my waterline. Just taking that. So that's simple. You just cannot see that white line anymore. Going to add this on the lower lash line as well and just buff it out. Or you can generally just add a little brown shadow and you can be good. But if someone wants to go to the next step and add kajal on the lower lash line as well, I'm showing how. But I personally would just add a little brown shadow under my eyes and I would, you know, be done. Because kajal makes my eyes look really small and I don't like that. So I'm just going to add a little on my waterline. I'm just going to kick off the bake as well. See, there was not much fallout, but in case if it was there also, it, you know, you can't see it because I baked it and it's just really smooth. So I just did that. Now I'm just going to buff out the lower lash line with that dark brown and the light brown. I'm going to mix those two. I'm just going to take the two shades and I'm just going to buff out my lower lash line. Make sure you always join your lower lash line and your upper lash line. Do that on this side as well. Next, I'm going to take my Fenty Beauty highlighter and I'm just going to highlight my inner corners and my eyebrow bone. So that is pretty much it for the eyeshadow, guys. Now you can add mascara and then you can add lashes. If you don't want lashes, you can just leave it with the mascara. I'm going in with my favorite mascara, the L'Oreal Lash Paradise. This like just gives so much volume to the lashes and I absolutely love it. So I'm just going to add a little mascara, pop on some lashes, and I'll be back. All right, guys, I am back with the whole outfit, the jewelry and everything. I love how this look turned out. This I know is a go-to look for so many girls. Like everybody, let it be night out or even if it's like an Indian, like, you know, wedding or anything, people try to do a black smokey. I've seen so many people do it. So I hope this was useful. You can totally go with a brighter lipstick. You can add a red lipstick if that is what you want. It look really beautiful. But since I already have a lot of red going on, I skipped it and I really like how this nude looks as well. So that's about it. So please like, share and subscribe to my channel and ring the notification bell so that you get posted every time I posted? No, so that you get notified every time I post, and I am going to post for 9 days for this Navaratri. So yes, hit that notification bell and I'll see you guys in tomorrow's video. Bye.